Hello, we've got the barbecue out today because there's an ever-increasing trend for outside cooking. For the first time last year, the UK became the largest market within Europe, with over £7 billion being spent. So in this video, we're going to talk burgers. We've got a classic beef burger, pork burger, lamb burger, and a choice cut rump steak burger as well. So our barbecue is set up for a good grilling temperature of about 250 degrees C, and the grill's nice and clean. So we'll start off, always apply a little bit of oil to your food when you're cooking. It'll just help to make sure that it doesn't stick. And for this, I'm using vegetable oil, which has a higher burning point than your standard olive oil. So we won't get any burnt flavors on our foods. So beef and the pork are on. Then we go with the lamb. And again, we're not looking to put too much oil, just a nice thin coat. Finally with that beautiful rump steak burger. Paper's off. We'll just paint the second sides before I forget, just so that when we go to turn them over, we know that we've got that oil ready on there. There we go. And lastly, there we go. Okay, so cook with the lid down, fats drip through, and that will create beautiful smoke that will circulate around the burgers and give them a wonderful barbecue flavor. Adding flavors to your burgers is a fantastic way of adding value, as well as adding products to your range. Things like barbecue flavor and chili flavors in your beef burgers, really, really popular amongst customers. And research also shows that if you name the cut, the primal, such as the rump steak, people are actually willing to pay more for them. So our burgers have had a couple of minutes on the barbecue, lid down all the way through, and we're gonna see whether they're ready to turn over. Really simple way to help your shoppers know when food's ready to turn over is if it doesn't stick to the grill. And we can see that that burger's just nice and easily coming away from the grate. We'll try the pork, same again, the lamb, and that rump steak burger, there we go. A really good and simple way to make sure that food's safely cooked is to always use a digital temperature probe. So we'll have a check of our burgers. We'll check the rump steak burger first. And for a good, well-done burger, we're looking at about 73 to 75 degrees. So that's ready, and we'll take that off using a separate spatula for cooked food. So that one can just go onto the board there. So these are ready to come off as well. There is a trend towards more medium burgers, but when you're talking to your shoppers, we'd always recommend that you make sure that they cook them through thoroughly. So I guess now it's time for the moment of truth, and we'll slice into these and just double check that they are as cooked on the inside as they look on the outside. So first of all, the beautiful rump steak burger, look at that, nice and juicy, cooked all the way through, nice caramelization stripes on the outside. Our lamb burger, again, nice and juicy, not overcooked, keeping it to that 73, 75 degree mark, just make sure that it's cooked, but not overcooked. The pork, looking really good. And then finally, our beef burger. There we go. Again, all four burgers beautifully cooked, nice and juicy, retaining their moisture, nice and consistent. So nice few little tips from the barbecues to the burgers, few ways to add value and products to your range. Hopefully these are really simple tips that you can pass on to your shoppers, and they can make sure that they cook beautiful food when they're at home.